Hi guys, welcome to a new season. This season, we are going to do the Sputnik Challenge. And the Sputnik Challenge in realistic mode, without loans, without exporting oil, bitumen, and I don't know what not. And this monument is huge. It's really big. Let me show you. If I have like a normal flat here, if I would put it next to the monument, something like so, here, look at the size. It's it's nothing, and size matters, I believe. So what are we talking about here? Well, where a normal construction would be 90 tons of concrete, 15 tons of gravel, this sweet monument only needs 344,000 workdays and 9,400 tons of concrete, 5,000 tons of gravel, but 6,177 tons of steel, 1,700 tons of asphalt, 8,100 prefab panels, bricks, boards, 824 electrical components. And the kicker is, we all need to manufacture it ourselves. And we can't have any loan, and we can only export stuff once we create everything by our own republic. So if I would want to export clothes, I couldn't, because I need fabric for clothes, and I need a grain for clothes, and I need to export that in order to in order to create fabric, we need, how do you call this? Chemicals and things like this. So that is, it's really difficult. And what I did in the previous season, where we exported vehicles, well, not so much, because I imported all the steel and all the fabrics. And so that would have been a very easy challenge, but that's not the idea of a challenge, right? That it's easy. Just to show you, we did in the last season, we had our vehicle production line here, and our city was here, the university was here, and this was our construction area. I just want to show you how big this monument is. I said it enough times, I think, but so what I want to do now, I'm so much looking forward to this. To just starting, and we're not going to do it on this map because I have unlimited money, but I just want to open this map because I wanted to show you the monument which we're going to build. So what I want to do first, go over the rules, because the Sputnik challenge has been around longer than the realistic mode has, so the rules which are currently in place have things like you can only auto-build a very tiny initial city. Well, that's not necessary because realistic mode. And so there are also other few rules which have changed now because realistic mode. So what I want to do, I want to first go over the original rules, also to give credit to the people who created that. So for that, I need to go to my browser. So these are the this is the initial Sputnik challenge, how would you call this, pamphlet, I think, which was created by the Cool.com Collected. Here you see it, the CCC. They have their own Discord, and they have more challenges like this. You have the I don't know how they are called, the Potemkin challenge and the Rasputin challenge. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. All very interesting to do. So these rules were created by the CCC with a special thanks to Bambaklot and Ryan the Skinny and everyone else who participated in the heated discussions. If I heated debating, if I can interpret that right, and I can only think that that must have been a lot of fun to do. So what these rules say, well, here are the buildings you need for your first starter town. Well, that's not necessary anymore because we are beginning in realistic mode. The same is all the presets you need to use. For this, the only presets we need to use is the realistic mode. We can start our own year, which is, oh well, I think we are going to with 1960. And also day-night cycles are optional. We are going to put that off because YouTube. And then here we have our goal. The target of the game is build the Palace of Soviet. All necessary resources produced in your republic after reaching self-sufficiency. No imports allowed the prior 12 months from either NATO or Soviet. This ensures your own resources are to be used to construct this monument to the glory of the Republic. You're only allowed to buy blueprints, which is obvious because otherwise how would you get the blueprints? And these rules have changed and have been adapted to realistic mode. And I did this with the CCC server. And we came up with these rules. So, well, this is the same. So, what the rules are. Helicopters and airplanes can only be self-manufactured. No buying of these. Exports are allowed only if all resources needed in the production chain up to and including raw resources are made in the territory of your republic. So, no importing. You are allowed 1500 points for immigration in the first year, and after that each year 360 points, and the points are the third world 1 point, basic workers 3 points, uni educated workers 6 points. And here we cannot export oil, bitumen, chemicals, UF6, nuclear fuel, bauxite, or bauxite. Bauxite, ore, or bauxite. Okay. And then we cannot have tourists until we have self-sufficient food, alcohol, and meat. This used to be a pretty good moneymaker, and nowadays that's less. Also, no modded heating or power plants allowed, so we cannot use the free power plant, which is a shame. Residential housing no bigger than 600 workers, so we can't use these huge towers, like the Ukrainian tower, which has, I believe, 2700 workers in it. No. No loans. Also, no import of water and no export of sewage. It is still a working document because I don't know how to create such a beautiful pamphlet out of this. But I think I'm going to ask there that we together can make the new rules on such in such a beautiful way. Here I am, because of the discussion, I am telling you which rules I suggest to remove because that's no longer necessary. So some comments and settings. Map is optional. The preset is realistic mode. Vehicles lock according to year or starting year. We are going to lock it according to starting year because I want to keep using them. The night day cycle optional. Well, we can also say certain months. Maybe we sometimes turn it on and sometimes off. And then there was also this area about a proof mod list. Well, we decided like a fair use policy, maybe something like that. Use mods that is fair. Don't use cheater mods, you know. Don't use the mods where you can create a huge construction office with 22 tons or something of boards. That you know it, you know yourself when something is not really right, okay? So, and those are the rules. And we're going to get started. So, what do we do to get started? Go to quit to menu. Yes. And then we are going to start a new game. So, I have been looking at maps. What maps we could use. I have been doing season 0 and season 1, which are both pretty short seasons, have been on the Three Sisters Island. So I've been downloading map, and every map I was like, you know, I would really like to explore the Three Sisters more. And I was like, you know, looking at maps. And it came to me, well, yeah, well, it's a very beautiful map, but it's not the Three Sisters. And I don't want to use the Republic of Fjordland because I've spent way too many hours on that map. And Taika, we're doing the round table in. So I thought, well, I'm going to go with the Three Sisters. And hopefully, after the challenge is done, I would like to explore it more. Because now I've spent like 20 hours in total for the first two seasons on this map. And it deserves more. It's such a beautiful map. So, the Three Sisters map. We're going on realistic mode. And so... What, this is Moving Sun, Always Day. I want to start in 1960. This is actually not a want. We need to start in 1960. I said want earlier, but it's a given. The vehicle's availability start according to year. So, let's get going. Whoop whoop. So, welcome to the Sputnik map. Let's first turn off auto by citizens before I do anything else, because I don't want to forget that at all. And I probably will. So let's take a look at our map. This is the Three Sisters map. I did a let's play where I was participating on a round table here. And here I created a helicopter construction, a steel area, which was constructed purely by helicopters. And we did our how to make what was it, 30k a month in the first year in realistic mode. So I know the map a little bit, but I want to explore it further. I've never really created anything, because in the last season we only had this part, and for that was that. So what are we looking at? We need to build the palace of Soviets. Oh, I forget the name. Is that's bad, right? Palace of Soviets. Well, we have to create our own concrete, our own steel, our own prefab, our own boards, also electrical components. I thought we also needed mechanical components, but we don't. So electrical components we need, mechanical components we don't. So we need to create our own steel. So we can see the Three Sisters here, and we have a border post there and a border post there. This is my previous start, but you can also start here because there is some oil here, but for the rest it's pretty empty, you see. And oil, the issue is in our rules. We can't export oil. We also cannot export bitumen, so we can only use it to export fuel. Truth be told, this is my second attempt to do this. The previous attempt I've failed in the way of... in October, in the first year, I realized that our 1500 points, which we can spend on importing people, you have to spend in the first year. And I didn't have anything of an initial city planned, which was actually here. So I tried to be ready before March 19, but no way, Jose. And that would mean that this series would have a very, very slow start. And I really didn't want that. So I decided, okay, let's just give up and try again. And this time, knowing all the rules, having everything accounted for. If I would have played for myself, I probably would have continued. But it's really boring to watch if you... because after the first year, you can only invite for 360 points. So that would be the equivalent of 60 university-educated people. Well, if you go from... It would be more like banished, how you would start. That wasn't really my intention. So... Second attempt. And well, in this episode, we're going to set up our construction offices and hopefully build the road, because I want to start here, because here's oil. And I want to create an electricity plant, a gas plant, based on oil. We can only use vanilla electricity plants, but this is a vanilla plant, power plant. So we can use that. Also, we have some uranium ore here. And where we cannot export UF6, wait a minute. The first stage is here, we create uranium ore, or we mine uranium ore, and here we are making uranium oxide. We could export that. So, and also for me, a reason to start here is we can use our dollars, because we had two border posts, so we are not stuck with only being able to use rubles, which you are here. So it makes it a little bit easier for us. So what I want to do, like I said, first we need to be able to get it, like here, because this is the area with the uranium ore and the oil. So what my intention is, I want to make a construction area here. Let me show you on the map where I am, which is here. So we can also construct there, and we construct more. If I create my construction area here, we can only go like this far. But that's quite a challenge, because this is I think 3 kilometers long road, which we need to construct first. Well, I did some tests, and my first test, the road was ready in October. And I can't have that, because then I would have the same thing. Like in October, I can start construction of my village, or my initial starter town. So let's dive in. What I want to do is create our construction area here. Press F1 and say, for instance, we want to start like here. And how would the road go? Think something like this direction or something. Sounds pretty straight to me. So then I'm going to, I did do tests here. So if you're seeing me setting things up and you're like, you know, this would take me ages, it's because it took me ages, only off camera. We need 4 of these. 1. 2. Go like this. No. 3. 3. 4. Okay, and now we need to remove these roads, because why did I only wanted to see if they were kind of straight. So, now you. Remove you, remove you, remove you. Okay, so then we can also remove you, and remove you, and remove a little bit of you. Like so. This does sound straight-ish to me. So, then on the other side, we are going to create 3 construction of turn you around. Turn you around, mirror you. And so something here. 1. 2. A little bit here. 3. That sounds about right. Do I want it like this? Yes, I would want it like this. And here, we're going to make the construction offices the other... how much we need 4 here? Well, this I find a little bit tricky. To be truthful, I'm going to recreate this road. Just for now, and that you can get straight. So I have a little bit of a helper line. Otherwise, I definitely will go all the way. Okay, again, construction office. So, about here. 1. 2. And I think I'm going to leave it at this. And I'm going to remove... I will explain it later, I promise you. This is going to be the... how do you call this again? The open storages which we need. Remove you. I was going to do. And remove you a little bit. Like so. Here we are having our aggregate storages, and here we're going to have our open storages and everything what has to do with electrical components or mechanical components we're going to buy at the border. So now we have an idea where our construction offices are going to be. So now I can kind of draw the road, which we have to go like so. So. Let me draw the road like so, and then kind of. Can you kind of go like so? Okay, like so. Is this a little bit nice? Let's remove you, because we wanted to have this road in one piece. So then, we have these construction offices, and we have a road going like so, I think. Is this all right? I guess so. So then we need a technical services, and we want the technical services to be near, turn you around, near the road. I'm not completely satisfied with the technical services here. And then we have two aggregate storages. And where are you? Here. Here. And one aggregate storage about here, I guess. And one here. Okay. So we need to connect these, because we need to have we need to build it, right? And these are the mechanisms, sorry. Is this all right? Yeah, I think it is. So we are going to need to have a road which actually can be used to get here. Where aren't you doing what I would like? Here. So what we have? We have two aggregate storages. These are for dumpers and mixers. They will get their gravel from here, and their bitumen and their asphalt, and what's the other concrete from the border. And then we have four open storages. Steel, bricks, prefabs and boards, and there will be two extra construction offices here with open holes which can get us stuff here, and these will be buses and cranes. I can't create those construction offices that because I need them here, because I want a temporary construction office here. And also probably here to be able to start building this road, because we are close to the border here. So that's why I'm not building those construction offices yet. But I'm not completely satisfied with our curve here. I want it to be a little bit organic. Like so. I think that's better. So then we can kind of upgrade you. Let's see if you are in one piece. No, you're not. So we need to remove you. Are you in one piece now? Certainly looks like it. So then we can upgrade you. And go all the way. Are you still with me? Yes. Okay, something like this. Then I want one construction office here. R and mirror you. Think like so. So, and then have your go like this, and have a road here. Like so. And then you can connect. Not here. I don't intend to connect there. Okay, then just do it like so. And maybe a little bit of... so that vehicles from the border can get on this road pretty quickly. We need... how do you call this again? A gas station. Here. Gas station. a gas station. You. Here. Approximately here. Oh, I clicked earlier than I anticipated. But this is all temporary, just for the initial setup, right? And we need another construction office here. RR. And kind of what you like. So. And then I'm going to want 3 distribution offices, maybe 4. Where are you? Where are you? Small distribution office. So, 1. Are you going to put like here and 1? This is the 3 sisters. The 3 distribution sisters. Like so. I want this to be not a one-way road. You can go. You can also go. Okay. Then I'll connect you. Like so. And what else? I think this is pretty much what I want here. Let's go back. Because what one of the issues was is we only have 7 construction offices. So that means we only have 7... how do you say this? We don't have a lot of room for buses to increase the construction speed. So, but also the buses need to go all the way there and back. And that is a huge thing. So we need a lot of buses. That is by far the best. So I wanted to create an additional construction office from the get-go. Like here. And we have, and now it's starting to get a little bit more. Maybe we are even going for a huge one. Large one. Well, this is pretty huge. Maybe we have enough for a large one. Yeah, so we have 20 parking spots and you cost 311 work days. You are a little bit more expensive, but you have 2 exits. And I don't know if 2 vehicles at the same time can exit here. That would be great if that could. 16. And large construction office. 32. Shall we try this? 20. 6, 5 days. 5.6. I do like these construction offices. Oh. So, 32 is too big. I'm sorry for 20. We're going for the 21. Okay. Decision's been made. So, would you like so, I guess? And not... okay, this is the road. Right, so we can upgrade you. But from here on, I am going to intersect a little bit and kind of put you like so, so that we can reach our construction office if you want to comply. No. And here as well. Because I want to create these roads. And I want to upgrade you from the start, to be honest. So I need to create some helper roads. So I can upgrade you and you and you. And it doesn't matter if you are also connected already. So we have construction offices, but we don't want them to look for their own constructions, because I don't want these construction offices to start creating this huge road here. No. And I want you to create these three first. First and first. These three first. And then this is medium. And this one, you are going to be a low priority. And then this can be, medium priority. Excellent. So this is an aggregate storage. So store gravel. Yeah, and here as well, store gravel. I will name this later. And here we need to say, well, okay, your gravel, get it from there. Asphalt. Can I connect? Yeah. And concrete, get it from there. The same we need to do for our other construction office here. We have you from there, you from there, and the aggregate storage is the other one. Okay, that's done. This is going to be our mechanisms. And we need, well, this we need a fuel station here. That's pretty essential, I think. So, fuel station here. Okay. Turn you around. Gas station. A little bit more room for that some vehicles can wait. Gas station. Okay. Then what's going to happen? If I invite the mechanisms from here and I say, well, by bulldozer, then this bulldozer, which goes 80 kilometers an hour, will take several weeks to get here. Oh, I didn't want you to build you there. Oh, you need to be close to the bulldozers, because the bulldozers, I wanted you to be here. Here. There. Crisis averted. Because the bulldozers here and the excavators will go and get their fuel there, and you don't want to get it all the way there. So this one has been removed now. Okay. So let's, first things first, let's set up everything. And what I'm going to do is, I don't have an extra construction office anymore, right? I built them all now. Yeah. What I want to do? Yeah, well, I want to remove one of the construction offices here. You go away for now. And I want to have one flatbed. And I'm going to invite our excavators and bulldozers here. And this flatbed is going to bring them there. So otherwise, we have huge traffic jams here. Because I want to deliver gravel there. And then there's this one bulldozer, which is creating a line. Now we have this extra construction office. Mirror you, turn you around. This is just temporary. So something like this, go like so. I just removed you. Okay, I needed to pause and unpause a little bit. Okay, so you. And what we first are going to do, we are going to invite an oil tanker there. And we are going to invite another oil tank there. Because what's going to happen, if I use one oil tank, that's going to go all the way here, deliver the oil. This gas station is going to go empty, and all our dumpers, which are going back and forth here, are going to refuel there, because this is apparently in range. I don't know, but yeah. So that first. And then we can, after the oil, we can purchase. What do we need there? One bulldozer. Two excavators and one open hull. And so, yeah. And then we can say you load there, unload there, load there, unload there. And we are going to load oil for now. Oil. And you, the same thing. Load there, unload all the way here. Load fuel. How? 60%? 60%, okay. That's for this. And then you are slowly, but now you only have to go here. So what I wanted to do in the other, how do you say this? In the previous season, maybe something like that, I used these dumpers as not to overcrowd our customs too much, but they are, wait, let's pause a little bit. Those are 17,000 and they go 35 kilometers an hour and are more, almost three times as expensive as our T-138 dumper. So I am going to buy more dumpers, like twice as much. Normally I would, I think, buy three to fill our, how do you say this? Our aggregate storages. So six, that would be one, two. Buy a dumper. Three, four, seven. Dumper. Five, six, seven. Okay. And so here, we are probably going to let them fuel up first. So otherwise, if this one, are you going for fuel? Yeah, you're going for fuel. Okay. So yeah, you need to get here first. Yeah, okay. Press play a little bit. So you are going to deliver your gravel there and there. And unload. And you can go to 80%. 80% because, oh, 80%. Hold on. 80%. So you're already having, what are you going to do? You're just going for fuel. Okay. Yeah, okay. Because these dumpers can carry 12 ton and 80% of 180, that's, you know, could even be 90%, but 80 is fine. So let's go back to the distribution office here. Then let's play again. We are almost an episode in now, but I want to get the road started. You can load this, and now you can also load this here. And then I'm going to press play a little bit so that you can also arrive in your habitat. So you can unload there and there. Hold on. Unload. 70-80. And did I check here? And you unload. Okay. I'm sorry, I need to have my customs first. Sorry for the going back and forth. Unload 40 for unload. Unload 50, 60, 70, 80. Okay. You don't go searching, because I don't want you to go to that road. So let's press play again. Now you are only fueling up. And what can we do? Now we can buy two dumpers. You are allowed to search. We can buy two dumpers here. Dumper, where are you? Here. One, two. And here also. Don't search. Dumper. One, two. We are spending a lot of money. I understand. Gravel. Get it from there. Gravel. Oh, go away. Get it from there. And wait a minute. Oh, my idea was that I am dividing a little bit. I bought a dumper too much, I realize. But that's okay. You are going to work somewhere else. Wait a minute. And then I want to say, I also want to buy some buses. You get your people from there. And you get your people from there. Like so. Okay. Did I buy two dumpers here, right? Yeah, it's a shame. You have to go somewhere else. Because we can use you at a later stage, but not now here. Let me see. Am I two dumpers? It doesn't matter. So, let's put you not there. Because that's going to be filled. But let's see if I can kind of... I have a road. So, you... Sorry, I changed my mind. Go work there. Okay. Go back. That's okay. So, let's press play. And then, here I want to buy two buses. And these are the buses which are 75 kilometers an hour. We for the first 10 years, we're only going to need 60. But 52 passengers for me is a nice number. But we also have changed our... thing that we have some minibuses in a bigger construction office which we are creating. I want this full of minibuses just to have a steady flow of people. And so, but for here I'm going to buy two of you, and I'm going to buy also two of you, and we are going to need a bulldozer. You. So let's let's hope that we have enough fuel for all to be... So are you... You are assigned to this road. You are assigned to this road as well. So what are you going to do? You are working for a distribution office. Okay, our first gravel is finding its way to our construction area. Let's speed you up a bit. Because you are so polite here. Don't go empty. Well, you are getting fuel again. But I think it's going to be all right. Okay. So now let's set the line. Okay, I can't create a line because I need a depot here. Oh yeah. So are we going to... Yeah, we can kind of have a temporary depot. Where are you? Like here. And now you can connect there. Something like so. So, and then connect you and say to you, go to the depot. And I don't need a long time for this. Okay. Now I can create a line. Load from there. Load vehicles. And unload there. So I don't have to worry about what you're doing. And also cancel going to the depot. So that was the usage for this depot. I will leave it. So we have a Stalinac here. We have, I think this is going to get started. Do we have, I think this is the first gravel. For now, just going to the aggregate storage. Let's speed you up a little bit. And we are getting new fuel here, which is excellent. So let's get started. I hope our bulldozer is going to get... where are you going? go there, I have to watch you all the time. Thank you. Oh yeah, that will be... wait a minute. Well, boss, yeah, now our... and I think our first workers are arriving because we are beginning with a road which needs 3,800 workdays and 1,000 tons of gravel. So yeah, that's a pretty huge undertaking at this moment. So, you have gotten smarter, which is great. Disable you, and let's see if we have set up everything. Well, we are still having tempers coming here. Yeah, we need to buy stuff here as well, right? Let's pray pause. Because here we are going to need vehicles as well. So we are going to need... this is dumpers and mixers, so 2 dumpers, 2 mixers. Same here. Purchase. Dumpers. 2 dumpers, mixers, 2 mixers. And, oh, let's assign you, and then say what we want to create. We want to create these ones. We want to create this road, this road, this road, and this construction office. So you had, I already did the priorities. So if everything goes well, we are going to start here. We need to say deliver mechanisms only with trucks. No, don't, because then the mechanisms which are here can start right away with doing their thing. So let's press play. We are a week now in, and yeah, because we press pause all the time, but we are creating a road, and there are 33 people working here. It's going pretty fast. Fast forward we are. Here come our mixers. And so our mixers can get right away to get concrete for our construction office. I think that the delivery of gravel will keep up. And so did I assign you? Maybe I can assign you more workers. Because I want... Yeah, excellent. I want all workers to be working here. So where's our blue... Why aren't you... This is obviously not working. So what... Okay. Well, go here. Then I have to do it manually, which I don't like a lot, to be honest. So, yeah, let's go home. That's so. Okay, well, hold on. Where are you now? Oh yeah, you had a line. I can't send you home, you were on a line. So that didn't do anything. Where's my... Where did you go? Oh, here. So, then, yeah, you are going to the depot. Excellent. So we're going to wait for that. This is going to be a little bit of a longer episode. We are 37, 47 minutes in-ish. And so I just want to have the how do you call this, the bulldozer to be sent. So, what was it? 3,400? Probably more, because now we are at 3,500. It's keeping up pretty nice with the gravel, I think. Hurry up. Okay. I don't know why you wouldn't load, but you were not intending to do. So, you... go work, and I'll probably forget it, but that is what it is. You go work there. I think it can't load from a construction office or something. It can only load from an open storage. I think it's something like that. Maybe we should have added an open storage, because you can now a vehicle storage, but there are no free vehicle storages. So yeah, we're getting our first gravel here. I'm going to leave it at that. It's April the 1st. It's not a joke. I hope you enjoyed this first episode. Next episode, we're probably going to look at creating our initial city while this road is constructing. I hope you enjoyed it and hope to see you next time. Bye bye.